Hey guys, JT Tran here. Now, I want to talk with Heather about your experience as a girl getting into the PUA or pickup artist community. Give a little bit of background. Actually, here, let me give you guys a little bit of background about Heather. She is one of her kind of part-time writers and occasional wing girl. Now, before this, before meeting me, what did you think of like the PUA community? Because it's very pervasive in the Asian community.
Yeah, well, to be honest, I didn't really know a whole lot about PUA. I hail from Mormon, Utah, where, I mean, it's kind of a rite of passage to just get married real quick.
Right.
So, you know, get your high school diploma and then get your wedding ring. So, I actually found an article. I think you had an interview with ABC or something.
Right, okay, yeah.
And I had posted this on another, like, Asian male activism group that I was, you know, very involved with, and just said, hey, here's this guy, and he's, you know, fighting for, like, Asian men here.
A dating activist.
Dating scene. Yeah, and I was like, hey, it's like all the practical applications of what we discuss in here.
Right.
So I thought it was very cool, and, you know, that was kind of the first step in getting involved.
Right. So your perspective of the PUA community was, what was it, after you learned about me?
Well, I mean, you kind of set the standard, really, in that was my first real experience. But then as I got more involved, I kept hearing more about other PUA things.
I might have set the bar too high, because let's be honest, some companies and some groups just do not follow a bit. I mean, I try to be ethical in what we do, because other companies, whether they are as ethical or they have a more technique-based, not that, you know, you should learn techniques as a guy, but theirs is more of a result at any cost, just at any cost. Mm-hmm. For example, I know this is a little bit sidetracked, but I was having a discussion with one of my boys last night, and he was saying that he had learned a couple things that was about pulling girls, and he was getting laid like left and right for these 2 months where he's like practicing this, but it was like results at any cost, right? And he got his head, you know, completely messed up where he just took a break after 2 months of that. And he was just like, he felt really just dirty, and he's just like, he could not look at himself in the mirror. And there's, you know, you have to have a balancing act, because I, as a teacher, have to look at the student and say, okay, what is both effective for him, but what is good for him over the long term? Because I can't simply give him, okay, just do this, and, like, you know, you just be an asshole to the girls. It's like, you want to develop them as a person over the long term, and it can't be simply just get as much pussy as you can.
Yeah.
Right? So, obviously, there are kind of like different segments of the PUA community. There's like the more Asian-oriented segment, and then there's more the Caucasian kind of dominated segment, which is, you know, it's Caucasian-run, but they're also teaching a lot of Asians, right? Basically, white guys teaching Asian guys how to be white. Here, I'm trying to teach Asians to be successful because you're Asian, not in spite of it, or not trying to act like white guys. But you have a sort of a funny story. But before we get into that, in your experience, did you see a large difference between like the different types of PUAs?
I really did. Your students and just your tactics in general are more respectful of women, which, being a woman, I tend to like. You know, it's, you come at the girls, you come at the sets as people, as individuals, as, you know, a number of infinite variables, and it's like, yeah, I'm a person, no. Yay! But there's other companies that are just, you know, it's just all about sex. You know, if she hasn't explicitly said no, she said yes. You know, and that's very self-serving for the man. Hey, you're gonna get the results you want, but at my cost. Mm-hmm. You know, at detriment to me. I can't get behind that.
Right. I mean, there are ways to build confidence up by building the man up, and there are other ways that they build confidence up by tearing other people down. Here I'm trying to build everybody up. But there's one time you're hanging out with us, you're like being our wing girl, and you know, we had like a very successful weekend, but it was like on Sunday, and we were just like exhausted, but like, okay, graduation night, right?
Yeah.
So tell the audience what happened here. We won't name any names, okay?
So we were just at more of like a lounge type of place.
It's very classy.
Yeah, and it was just a really, I mean, we had just built up this camaraderie between the students, and we were hanging out, you know, kind of sad that this was the last hangout, but, you know, enjoying our time.
Yeah, these boys, it's quite an experience seeing these boys grow up before your very eyes. Like these guys that might have never talked to a black girl or talked to a white girl, never have gotten a girl's number or never have kissed a girl, and to see them do that, it's like you're a proud mom and dad.
So proud, seriously, you know, where there's just so many emotions going on that night because I was gonna miss them all. And you know, I had to use the restroom, you know, and I came back, and you kind of had taught me how to spot a PUA.
There's very obvious things.
Yeah, and I had spotted the PUA, but you know, I could see him kind of, okay, here she is, kind of doing the whole strategy in his head, and I'm like, you know what, I'm not gonna fucking change my trajectory because this asshole is gonna pick me up. God damn it, I'm gonna walk down this, what is it, the aisle there, and like, whatever he does, I'm just gonna tell him no anyway.
Okay.
And, so he did. He was facing a different direction and I was walking through. He backs up and he grabs my, like, I'll just show you. So he kind of grabbed like this and he made me put his arm around my waist. So like if I'm the guy, this is what he did. And he was making me walk with him and forcing me to walk. And he's just talking.
And it wasn't like compliance. It was just like, just. Okay.
Yeah, and he's just forcing me, and he's trying to talk me, he's trying to lead me into his group, he's trying to get me out of where I'm going. I just didn't want to have anything of it. I was still walking back to you in the group. And finally he just goes, wait, just tell me why you don't like me. And I just went, well, because you're not Asian. And he just goes, oh, well then I'm going to lead you over to my friend. Let me tell you about my friend. And he, you know, led me to you, and you had said like, hey, I see you've met my friend Heather. I'm like, oh my God, the color in his face just drained. It was so funny.
Yeah. I mean, there's just a lot of different styles out there. And you as a guy, you've got to like choose. Like the way we approach our methodology and the way we approach women is a more kind of holistic way. Like that's more well-rounded, more respectful to us as men as well as women. And the thing is with girls, like you want to lead them, right? If she's attractive, but you don't want to be that kind of douchebag. You don't want to be playing like frat boy game. And that night, it was like they actually got kicked out.
They did. And like, we got questioned because they thought that we were with them.
Well, the thing is like, you know, this bouncer, all of a sudden I'm just like standing there talking shop, and this bouncer comes up, grabs him by the neck, and like pulls him out of the car. I'm like, what the fuck just happened? and like the bouncer comes up to me and I was just like, what happened? And he's like, oh, these, you know, this guy and his group were just harassing girls, not just like talking to them, because that happens at any bar or club. Like they were physically harassing and that's why they got kicked out. I'm like, well, I'm glad my boys don't do that. Because there's a right way and a wrong way to touch girls, and that's definitely something that we teach. Like I said, you want to lead, I think you want to be assertive, but there is a point where just it goes into aggressive douchebaggery. Like, don't be a douchebag, guys. You can get girls without being a douchebag. It's about humanizing. I know like people ask, like, well, you're just teaching Asian guys how to pick up white girls. Aren't you just objectifying them? Aren't you just like showing Asians inferior or white women are inferior? Like, I like to use the term, I'm humanizing each other. Where so many Asian guys think white girls or black girls, they're up here. Or they go the complete opposite route, like I'm gonna be a douchebag and I'm mistreat girls, and so they put women down here. Like, you don't wanna put them on a pedestal, but you also don't wanna put them as subhuman. They are equal, and so you humanize the women to you, and so you treat them as an equal, because that's the base of a lot of problems, is like you're treating these girls not as like a new friend, but someone that is like, you know, she's too good for me or she's below me. But also at the same time, you as an Asian man, you become a role model for others, because this white girl, black girl, might not have ever even thought of dating an Asian guy. So now you're putting yourself as a viable dating partner. Now she's thinking of you in a very human and a very masculine and sexual human being, like, oh, maybe I could date him. Maybe I could go out with him, have sex with him, marry him. So you're really, that's how you defeat stereotypes, is showing other people that two people of different races can connect intimately. Any last words when it comes to all the kind of the P-Ways and your experience as a white girl getting into the P-Way community for the first time?
Yeah, just generally with just PUA, the only real exposure I'd really ever had was with your company. And you hear all these negative things about other companies in the PUA industry at large. And, you know, even though we haven't really worked so much recently, I would always come to your defense because I know ABCs of attraction and I know your strategies. And they are, you know, based in equality. They're based in, you know, many of the feminist tenets that they actually like. You know, because it is all about equality and it's about respect.
Okay.
And so, like, any real feminist would be able to get behind this.
Well, you know, tell the audience, if some girl or some guy that didn't really know anything about my company and wanted to label me with the broad strokes of just, oh, he's PUA, so they're all like douchebags, what's different about like my company in your experience versus like, you know, the experience that you've had with other companies?
What sets your company apart really is that you actually qualify why the guys are there.
Okay.
You know, you'll ask them, what are your goals? That one boot camp that we went to, that I went to with you, it was, you had five different students with five completely different goals. And you were able to help them at their varying levels. You know, one guy couldn't even say hello to a girl versus another guy who was like, didn't he like fuck close the second? You know, it's like you had completely different levels and you were respectful of that all and you were still respectful of the women. And that is different than other PUA companies where I think from the beginning it's, well, it is about, you know, sex. It is purely about, and that's all it is. And for you, that's just not the case.
Right. I think for me, I recognize that students are different. I don't simply try to clone myself on them because, yes, people come to me because I'm Asian, but I'm Asian American, right? I'm not necessarily an Asian immigrant who can barely speak English. So what I do for them is I'll give them the kind of tactics that works for them. I don't simply clone myself as the Asian playboy and make them do the same things because, you know, because they're foreign. So them learning a lot more of the verbal skills and bantering is not going to be as effective, right? As opposed to like an Asian American, but even on that one particular boot camp that we're talking about, you know, there was a white guy on there too.
Yes.
So what I would teach him is going to be slightly modified for him. Again, I'm not forcing him to be me. I'm giving him the tool set and he can mold and plug and play his own personality into it. Anything else?
Just that I think even women could get behind your company because I feel that if women are going to put in the effort and the time to do makeup and hair and, you know, learn things that are ascribed for our gender, why can't men learn tools and tricks that are going to help them?
To invest in ourselves.
So I just think that it's part of the game. Another thing that I'd really like to add is that, I mean, I'm a woman. This is not something that I could get behind if it wasn't ethical. Like, this is humanizing for me. This is humanizing for my gender. So to be able to walk up to one of your students, hear that he's one of your students, I know I'm going to be treated right.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you do have this code of ethics that your students do have to follow. I remember you getting upset when one student actually was kind of straying off your path, you know, and you're like, no, you've got to be ethical. And that's really what it's about.
Okay. All right. Well, thanks for the kind words. And I hope that you guys and girls that are watching this and you know, you have some knowledge of the PUA community, understand a little bit of the nuances, especially what I'm trying to teach, because I think of many of all the companies, I would call myself kind of like a dating activist, because our company was founded when this Chinese-Canadian mother called me up to help out her son who had been harassed by neo-Nazis. So it was more than just going out there and banging bitches and all that kind of stuff. It was defeating stereotypes and showing this 18-year-old kid that he didn't have to live in fear, that he was just as equal as any other person, and I just had to give him the skill sets. And, you know, from there, you want a lifestyle and you want to have and be that success that you always meant to be and get that woman that makes you a better man. So thank you so much, Heather. All right, guys, thanks for watching. Be sure to subscribe and check out our next video. Bye.
Bye.
Hey, guys, JT Tran here. Now, today I'm bringing back Heather. Some of you might recognize her as one of her writers and contributors and Wing Girls once upon a time. So in case you don't know, Heather loves Asian guys. Is that right?
Well,
like one of the most popular like t-shirts we've ever written about. Like every girl wants to know, like, where do I get the Asian boys are better t-shirt? So she only dates Asian guys.
Yeah, it's